The content filtering system is powered by Azure AI Content Safety, and it works by running both the prompt input and completion output through an ensemble of classification models aimed at detecting and preventing the output of harmful content. Azure OpenAI model deployments are equipped with a default content filter, which sets all severity thresholds to medium. However, customers who have been approved for modified content filtering have full content filtering control, including configuring content filters at severity level high only, or turning off content filters. Let's view the content filters in action by testing a few prompts that contain suggestive language. My deployed model is grounded with a dataset of Contoso outdoor store products and is configured to answer questions about the products. The first prompt I'll submit inquires whether it's possible to have sex on the Contoso Trekmaster camping chair. The model generates a response which indicates that the input is inappropriate and follows up with the proper use of the chair. But what were to happen if I used slang in place of the word sex? I'll now try another prompt which asks about which sleeping bags are large enough to fit two people to do the deed. In this case, do the deed refers to the act of having sex. This time around, the model generates an output that the requested information isn't available. So, at present, the model sometimes identifies inappropriate content when explicit terms such as sex are used. However, I'd prefer that the model also accounts for alternative phrasing and terms for sexual activity. To add another layer of risk mitigation, I'll create a content filter that blocks sexual input and output. Here in the content filters screen, I'll create a new content filter and assign my Azure OpenAI resource as the connection. Next, for the input filter, I'll lower the threshold for sexual content to low. As for the output filter, I'll also lower the threshold for sexual content to low. I can now add my sexual content filter to my existing deployment or choose to do so later. I'll add the content filter now. And finally, I'll review my configurations and create the filter. If you recall from the prompts I tried, I was able to pass in prompts which contained sexual innuendo without triggering the default content filter. What I could now do to mitigate the possibility of such terms not triggering the content filter is to create a blocklist of terms to block. Within the content filters, I'll navigate to the blocklists tab and select Create Blocklist. I'll name this blocklist Sexual Slang and select my Azure OpenAI resource as the connection. In the description field, I'll state that this list contains a list of sexual slang terms. After the list is created, I can start to add terms to the list. Since I already have a list of my terms within a CSV file, I'll do a bulk add and upload the file. Now that the sexual slang blocklist is created, I can add the blocklist to the sexual content filter. To do so, I'll need to go back to the configuration of the content filter and select the blocklist toggle, followed by the blocklist on the input filter page. I'll make the same change for the output filter as well. Since everything else is staying the same, I won't make any other changes. Since I made a change to an existing content filter, I'm prompted to replace the content filter that's already applied to my GPT-4 model deployment. From here, I'll save my changes and head back to the playground to test the filter. Back in the playground, I'll try the same prompts from earlier. Like before, the model identifies that the first prompt, which uses the term sex, is inappropriate. I'll now submit the prompt that uses the phrase, do the deed. This time, the model generates a response which insists that the content is inappropriate and provides a safety precaution regarding product use. To get started with content filtering, visit ai.azure.com.